Alright, so good evening. I'm gonna talk about the ego killer. And the ego killer in this instance being the government of Texas. Not, interestingly enough, it's not the government of the United States, it's the government of Texas. I have been trying for, I don't know, 5, 6, 7 months now to obtain the correct identification paraphernalia for my father so he can obtain a state identification card. Just the card. Okay. He's a messed up case because he didn't have, when he was born one name, and then in the middle of his teenage years he switched to another, and you know, we're talking years and years and years ago, and it was never recorded as a legal moment for Texas. However, for some reason, California accepted his new name when he was a teenager. The government of the United States accepted it on his passport. So he drove under his new name for 60 years, and he had a passport in the federal government for 60 years under his nickname. And so now here he is now in Texas. And Texas is like so tight, I can't believe it. I've given the passport. And that had to be redone. They did not accept expired. I had to go get a brand new passport. So there you go. There's more money. And then I had to go and just endless things that I had to obtain. And then I'm like, well, we can go back and even get high school records, apparently. And they were not found. I searched, we went, and they're like, no, we don't have them here, you have to go back to another school. And then finally today they said, we don't even want his high school records any longer, we only want his social security card. And okay, so fine. And then the 1099 that it says that they would accept, they didn't accept, because it had an initial from the alphabet associated with it. It was 1099 hyphen an alphabet number, a letter. So it was not accepted. It had to be something called 1099. All right. And apparently that only had 4 digits of his social. And so that didn't qualify. So she burned that today in a singe. And so I'm like, well, because we really wanted to keep the name that the old man's been using for 60 years. You know, it's only fair. California let him do that. The federal government, he's traveled the world with it. And no, we're here in Texas and they want his little baby bambino infant name. And so we have to go back to that. And it's just a catastrophe. Because I had to go get Social Security. I've had to go get the Medicare. I've had to go back to the, what do we call this place? They wanted an affidavit. They wanted a name change. I found out today, I was there at the courthouse, and they want $300, $298, to change his name. The first name only. Okay, so I said, well, that's not going to happen, so we have to go back to his bambino name. So we're going to go back to the infant. What a disaster. What an ego trip this government has been on that has tried to, it has superseded the federal government of their identification process. It superseded them. So I don't know. I mean, I figured the passport's a passport, and you know, that's accepted the world over. It used to be, but not here in Texas. Not here in Texas. They are really clinchy to this thing called the Social Security card. So, whatever that name is on that card. Yeah. They don't care about your banks. They don't care about anything else. It's just what's on that Social Security card. And I was told different. You know, one person mentioned I didn't even need it, and then another one said today that if I don't have it, just forget it. And then I'm like, well, what's going on here? Do I have to pay more DIDA? You know, I know I'm close to the border. Do I have to put, you know, slide, you know, 20 across? Because I just keep getting another wall. And I'm starting to wonder, you know, do I have to actually give them cash right here at this DMV? You know, their aggression level is so haughty. They are so belittling. And you know, and then they write down on their little things. Oh, you need this, you need that, and then your secondary, you need two of these in the secondary. And so in one section, it says you need two things in the secondary, and yet it is a lie. They came up with other things. No, you have to have Social Security. So they lie in one instance on that piece of paper. So you actually need three things on that secondary. You cannot have a, anyway. So anyway, it's just been hell. A title of a vehicle, even though it's here in Texas, does not officiate him as a human being here in Texas either, or help. It doesn't help. No. Going back to that Social Security. So I've been to that office with my father now 3 times, and it's difficult on him, and I'm really, I want to sue the state, because they've dragged my father around to all of these offices. They forced him to do all of this, and this is the only way, this is just for simple things, so he can get a bus pass, so he can get a library card, so he can get, what's another thing that's simple? So he can get an exemption from the state. They have an exemption because you're an elderly, small one, it's not great, but it's something. As a homeowner, you get exemption. And if he doesn't get his ID in Texas, he doesn't get the exemption. So I just feel like, you know, there's just been too many hoops, too many trips I've had to make to these DMVs, too many trips to the courthouses, too many people that don't even know what they're doing. I sat today at the Social Security now for 2 hours, and was shifted to one guy, and then over there to the back to the chairs, and back to this other guy again, and then over there to the chairs, and then back to another place. And this other place, finally the guy says, no, you need a court affidavit, David, a court order. Okay. Meanwhile, you know, my father is old man, he's practically, you know, losing his bladder, and I'm like, you have got to tell me right now where that address is, so he can go to the toilet and we can get out of here. Enough of this. There comes a point when they have abused my father. They have abused him. And I don't know who to even call or talk to about it. It's just the worst situation ever. Anyway, so that's where I'm at today. I'm feeling a little distraught, and I couldn't sing. I couldn't do my practice. Dang it. Because where my voice is it really needs, you know, that. I really need that at least 3 days in a row, you know, to get it feeling more velvet. Otherwise, I'm just shredded, you know. Anyway, gosh dang it. So yeah, so we're talking, you know, we're talking this exemption, you know, we're talking, you know, it could be $600, it could be 1,000, I don't know. Hopefully it's 1,000, but I think it's 600, something like that. But he can't get it unless he has this Texas state ID. So then I'm like, well, put the house in my name. Still doesn't qualify because I'm not old enough. I may look it, but I am not old enough to get that exemption. So it's just put everything in the worst situation ever. You know, we're talking, now I have to switch the name of the house to his baby infant name. I mean, it's disaster. A disaster. And each time I'm at these bureaucratic office of Texas, except the court order place. I mean, she responded right away to my tears. I was, oh, I'm so sorry. But no, when I'm at this DMV, when I'm at this homestead exemption place, they throw these bouncer guys out, and they go, they write the bouncer male, there was a bouncer male at that homestead exemption place, an intimidator, and he was the scariest thing ever, and they brought him out. And then there was another at this woman at the, just today, she didn't need the bouncer, she did it herself. Don't you dare talk to me that way, you know, one of those. And I'm like, whoa, I am in serious, like, agony here of belittlements, and these people are trying to drop me off my ego. They're trying to delete my ego, you know, really bad. And I told another woman the last time I was there, I said, you're just bad people. You're just all bad people. There need to be exceptions. There comes a time when your offices have to make exceptions to the rules. Anyway, been wretched. It's just wretched. And it's ruining me. And I'm getting older by the minute, and they're just destroying me. I can't stand Texas. I should never have moved here, ever. I hate it. I hate this government. It has nothing to do with what it should be. I just hate them. Biggest mistake ever. And I'm like, well, I should have moved to New Mexico at least, but I couldn't because my dad needs to visit his sister, you know. And that's that, you know, he needs to see her in her years, you know, her aged years. So I'm here. Anyway, yeah, so I feel belittled by them, and I'm like, oh. I don't know how to fight it right now, aside from I can't stand that guy, that deshik guy, always throwing the salt off his shoulder. Yeah, I have to do that, but I'm so tired of the salt throwing. I'm just so tired of it. I'm so tired of their ego trip. And yeah, a little bit more money, and a little bit more money, and a little bit more money. And tomorrow I have to give some more money there to the DMV. If it goes through, if they start to accept even his infant name. And then I have to, like, go to this courthouse and then give them money. And it has to be cash instantly. It can't be even, they won't even take a check, a personal check. It has to be cash. Isn't that convenient? Or a cashier's check. So I'm like, well, that's an odd place already that I'm setting myself up to go to that only takes cash or a cashier's check? I don't know. Maybe there's just like a mafia that runs this state of Texas. I'm starting to think there's a mafia because the rules are so stringent. yet they're odd because they allow, if you are a prisoner, they like prisoners here as identification. If you have prison identification, they're very happy. That qualifies as a supporting document. Really odd. That's one of their main things. If you have a weapon handler permit, you are also wonderfully applauded and you can get identification. As long as you have Social Security. Yeah, infuriating. Infuriating. Anyway, yeah. And I told the lady one time I was there, I said, well, so he has to go and rob a bank. And then he gets an ID from the incarceration moment. And then he can come back here. And she said, well, yes, in essence, yes. But she was wrong, because later on today, the other woman says, I need Social Security card in that name. So, anyway, luckily I have it, because I've already gone there, I've already done that, we already stood in that line. But it's just the drama event. You know, when you're dealing with the older person and he's lost his Social Security card, you know, a few months ago and I had to go get it again, I'm swamped with them. The paperwork people that are, I think they are their own little country here in Texas. So yeah, no fun. If you have a driver's license, supposedly that's great, but not if your baby name doesn't match your driver's license. It has to match exact. Anyway, and it can't be expired. It cannot be. At one point they said expired is okay, and they said, oh, and then they went and checked. They said, no, you can't have that one. So it's almost like they made up a rule special, because I've read that he's allowed that. But I don't, anyway. So then I'm like, well, maybe they're just trying to play with my brain by giving me a list so difficult that I cannot comply with it. And I'm like, well, you know, is this a personal attack? And I even asked, I said, when did they print this paperwork? Was this recent? And she says, well, she thinks it's been 5 years. They've had these heinous rules. Maybe, I just don't get it. I mean, identification, not to drive a car. This is just the ID. You know, that's just the ID. You don't do anything with the ID. So I don't understand what's the big gluttony of importance with it. You know, the only thing you can do with it here is helps out with your property tax, a little bit. So it feels like this is something that they are doing on purpose, to even stop the people from getting a little small exemption. You know, make it one big deal harder for them than to get the cheaper. I think it's like $5,000 a year here, property tax on most houses. Very high. So when we're talking about a little miniature exemption and then being denied it, it's just a terrible atrocity here of bureaucracy, of meanness to people. I don't know how to stop a huge amounts of property tax because it's as high as an apartment's rent. It's just horrible. Because you're not getting your money worth at all. There's no money worth it. You're not getting any benefits from it. It's going into somebody else's pockets. It's just paying somebody. It's not paying, not paying the city streets. It's not paying, no. I'm sorry, they've been working construction very slowly. So anyhoot, I don't know. Anyway, it's tough not to get emotionally attacked by their big power trip.